A brief history of horror. The devil. Lucifer, the prince of darkness. Beelzebub, Satan. There are many names for this, the most evil character. Across many cultures, he is the foil to all that is good and pure, and the tormentor of the wicked. He is the ultimate trickster, terror of the faithful, hero of the counterculture, and all-around ultimate bad boy of horror. In Judeo-Christian tradition, Satan is an angel who rebelled against God and as punishment was banished into the depths of the earth. He is the serpent that tempted Eve to commit the first sin, resulting in her banishment from the Garden of Eden. In the bowels of hell, he rules over the damned and their eternal torment. And when Jesus wanders the wilderness, it is Satan who tempts him to turn his back on his Father. Many other religions and cultures have similar characters. In Zoroastrianism, one of the earliest known religions and precursor to monotheism in the Fertile Crescent, God, known as Ahura Mazda, has twin children, Spintu Mainyu, beneficent spirit, and Angra Mainyu, hostile spirit. The duality of these characters is the central view of human nature in this religion. Spintu represents all goodness, Angra, all evil. The ancient Greeks feared Hades, the god of the underworld. He was the brother of Poseidon, the god of the sea, and Zeus, the ruler of all the gods. His misty and gloomy realm was where all mortals met their ultimate judgment. Buddhism has Mara, a demon who represents temptation of the flesh, the wages of which are eternal death and separation from nirvana rather than reincarnation. Mara uses his own beautiful daughter in an attempt to tempt the Buddha away from the path of enlightenment. Satan is a common theme in visual art. Christianity, big on borrowing ideas from early pagan religion, took the popular image of the devil from the mischievous Greek god Pan, who was a human-goat hybrid with horns and cloven hooves. His pitchfork is thought to have come from Poseidon, god of the sea. In medieval Europe, fear of eternal damnation was used by the church to terrify the faithful into appropriate behavior. Thousands of people were accused unjustly of being witches in league with the devil and were tortured, hung, or burned at the stake. In the 14th century, Dante Alighieri's epic poem, Divine Comedy, begins with a tour through Inferno, or Hell. Dante is guided down through the 9 fiery circles of the afterlife, where the damned are tortured in ways fitting their earthly crimes. The work shaped the popular vision of hell from then on. The German legend of Faust tells the tale of a doctor who is unsatisfied with life and makes a pact with the devil, exchanging his immortal soul for unlimited knowledge and earthly pleasure. This story has been replicated in many works of art through the ages, most famously by English playwright Christopher Marlowe in 1588. In John Milton's 1667 epic poem, Paradise Lost, Satan is portrayed as a tragic anti-hero destroyed by his own hubris. This work is often cited as the basis for his status as an icon of counterculture and a rebel against the establishment. During and since the Enlightenment, the educated disdained the belief in the devil as mere superstition, but superstitions are hard to shake, as evidenced by how frequently Satan pops up in pop culture. In the early 1900s, jazz and blues music, primarily played by African Americans, was so feared by white America that it became known as the devil's music. In 1936, Robert Johnson claimed that he met the devil at a crossroads and sold his soul in return for becoming a great blues guitarist. Johnson was murdered a year later, becoming a founding member of the 27 Club and fanning the flames of his legend. 1926 silent film Faust and 1941 talkie The Devil and Daniel Webster both tell versions of the Faust legend. In the swinging 60s, Anton LaVey founded the Church of Satan, which became a popular hedonistic scene among the rich and powerful. Members allegedly included Sammy Davis Jr., Jane Mansfield, and Liberace, who frequented orgies at LaVey's infamous Black House. 1965's Eye of the Devil portrays a black mass. Real-life black magician Alex Sanders was consulted on the film to ensure that the ritual was depicted accurately. 1967's Bedazzled put a comic twist on the Faustian legend. In 1968, Mick Jagger sings in the character of Lucifer in the Rolling Stones' hit song, Sympathy for the Devil. 1970s America was in a hangover from the free love of the previous generation. Women's liberation, civil rights, and a massive recession meant huge cultural shifts, and many young people felt disenfranchised from the American dream. Rock bands like Black Sabbath, Alice Cooper, and Judas Priest groomed an air of counterculture mystique that flirted with the satanic and drew in hordes of young fans. Mothers warned that the moniker of the band Kiss stood for Knights in Satan's Service, which, by the way, is untrue. The division between generations and the sense that the young were rejecting wholesome values in favor of debauchery led to a rash of brilliant and eerie films that bring parents' worst nightmares to life. In Rosemary's Baby, an expectant mother is haunted by creepy dreams and stalked by creepier neighbors until she gives birth to the son of Satan. The Exorcist sees a sweet and innocent girl spew profanity and pea soup when possessed by a demon. Priests try desperately but in vain to rid the girl of her plight. The movie pushed the envelope for major cinema horror and deeply disturbed many audience members. In The Omen, when the infant son of a politician on the rise dies in the hospital, he is secretly replaced with an orphan who grows up in wealth and privilege. But as the child grows, mysterious and ominous deaths surround him, and it becomes clear that little Damien is in fact the Antichrist. 70s Britain was also obsessed with the occult, as evidenced by the many demonic offerings of Hammer Horror Studios, including The Devil Rides Out, Blood on Satan's Claw, and The Satanic Rites of Dracula. In one of Stephen King's most popular novels, and my personal favorite, The Stand, survivors of a worldwide plague are haunted by terrifying dreams and eventually must confront a demon in human form, Randall Flagg, who has gathered his followers in Las Vegas. In the 80s, as more women entered the workforce and children were left in the hands of daycares, fears began to grip the nation, fueled by fundamentalist Christian leaders and sensationalist journalism. Childcare workers across the nation were accused of belonging to abusive satanic cults in what became known as the Satanic Panic. Reputations and lives were ruined in the mass hysteria, but evidence of the alleged abuses were rarely found. In the 80s and 90s, the devil becomes a slick man in a suit, more cunning and deceptive than ever before. Angel Heart sees Robert De Niro as Louis Cipher, who hires a detective to track down a man who owes him his soul. In The Devil's Advocate, Keanu Reeves is the son of Satan, Al Pacino, in the guise of a wealthy New York lawyer. The son must decide if wealth and privilege are worth defending the truly evil. Jeff Goldblum is Mr. Frost, the devil committed to an insane asylum. And in Prophecy, a creepily poetic Lucifer is engaged in an epic otherworldly power struggle. Satan is in the business of seducing women in The End of Days and The Witches of Eastwick. A more traditional depiction of a demon, played by Tim Curry, can be seen in Legend. In the 2000s, the devil can often be found in comic fare, such as the childish Satan in South Park, Adam Sandler's dad in Little Nicky, and wisecracking Hades in Disney's Hercules. But there is still a healthy dose of fear for the devil, as seen in DC Comics' Hellblazer and its film adaptation Constantine about a man who can see demons on Earth. Devil, in which five strangers are trapped in an elevator and one of them is Satan. And Drag Me to Hell, where a woman is cursed by a gypsy and terrorized by demons himself. 2016 comedy series The Good Place sees a group of people in a strange but delightful version of heaven. However, in the end of season one, the main character discovers that they are in fact in hell, and the demon in charge is there to subject them all to personalized psychological torture. So what's your take on Lucifer, absolute evil incarnate and the seducer of the wretched sinner, or misunderstood rebel and hero of the counterculture? Let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for more horrifying videos. Thank you for watching.